Looking at is all those citizens, black, white, everything in London saying to the police, you know what? We've had it. This is bullshit.
An endless sky.
They better be glad that's not LA. Them LA cops would have popped a cap in their ass. And in Detroit and New York. That's how those soldiers will run up on your ass with those pistols and force you to those concentration camps. They can shoot you down, you run and get away then. They don't mind killing you, they take you to the concentrate to kill your ass anyway. So they'll bust a cap in your ass after they shoot 10 or 12 people. The rest of the people will be abiding. That run, walk your ass right where they want you to go.
Like the trembling heart.
See, the reason why people loot during riots is because they feel that the stuff that they've been deprived of, even though they gave so much money for it, is housed inside of all the stores where they're going to spend their money. Because in reality, they are. Because all those stores are owned by the government, who fool you into being the proprietor. But every penny you make, you end up giving it right back to the ass anyway. So as you can see, they've had it with the police. And the police is running. They're getting the hell out of Dodge, see? Do you see? And they just had it. Get the hell out of our neighborhood. We won't be paying no more cable bills. We're not paying no light bills. You're going to put some good food in our stores and stop filling up our streets with crack all the damn time. This is Toronto. That one right there we just visited was London. Let's go see what's happening in Toronto after the commercial. You know it'd be real nice if they had a commercial station that they made you maybe look at 5 minutes of before you could use the other channels. Of course, they know people just turn their shit on and let it run without you being there. I just don't like advertising being forced on me like that. I don't. And it's been that way all my life. That's the reason why I'm really pissed off with it at 52 years old. And I believe most of the subliminal suggestions that you get come to you when they let any damn person make a commercial and send it to you. Because that person might have some other messages that they're trying to get out to you for a commodity they want you to buy that's going to make way more money than the freaking chewing gum that they clothing on. They use that product to get into the system, but then the subline product that they sell you as is violence, homosexuality, or crack, or Jesus, all that shit. You won't see it because it moves so fast past your conscious, but your subconscious mind get it. It's all in there all the time. You see, when they made the Star Wars episodes with the stormtroopers, this is what they were preparing us for right now. See, you remember the breathing apparatus that Luke Skywalker had on? Not Luke Skywalker, but James Earl Jones. What did they call him in the movie? But remember he had the big thing over his face and it always sounded like it was a breathing apparatus? And he had the big black helmet and everything. This is what they were preparing you for. Now that you see this, you grew up with it as a child, so it's not startling to you. Because you saw it in all those Star Wars episodes. And everything else was Star Trek and you name it. And all the 60s riots, movements, and everything. They always keep the stuff right in your hard drive so when it surges again, you already know of it, so it's nothing for you to double react to it. Unless you have somebody out here like me narrating the shit and letting you know, oh yeah, you do need to double react with this shit. Because they're already talking about bringing foreign soldiers over here. And that's why they always kill innocent black men, because we're sacrificial rituals to their Lucifer God. And so all of this right here is what you're gonna see coming to be the description they gave you in all the Arnold Schwarzenegger movies, the Terminator. This is what it's all about. They got the cyborgs and vehicles that's gonna use toxic warfare on your ass. They have canned spray, pepper spray, all kinds of stuff. I'm sure they got spray that can spray you that'll kill you instantly too if need be. They probably bring helicopters and drop them on the ground, and once they explode, they probably would take the breath away from everybody in the riot zone. Some ammonia or something. I'm sure they got all that stuff. I'm sure they do. Because they're wicked devils like that. You know, they just fucked up. They really are. And you guys don't know. You think that I always perpetuate this because I don't have anything else to do. You know, when this stuff going on, no one's going to be able to say that they were not aware of this because it's not only me out there putting in work. Yes, other people out there putting in work too. to let everybody know that we got some bizarre circumstances going on here on our planet. People better wake up and pay attention. And that's why I use so much profanity, because I want you to know this ain't no damn game of checkers. This shit is chess. And you need to adjust your paradigm of thought for this game right here. And get your ass off of SpongeBob and Jesus across the snowman and Santa Claus. You don't have no time for that bullshit. No time at all. All these people standing on here is ready to cut your throat if they can't get to the people to throw beef and cut or turning off all the water and the food and the lights coming real soon. All that. How do you think they're going to control the masses of people when they all get together and start acting even more uncontrollable than they are right now? I can tell y'all, they're going to turn the water off and the lights. You know, too busy trying to get water and heat there to worry about fighting them. Who's gonna have soldiers with TV dinners and everything that know if I don't stay here fighting on this side, I'm gonna be out there with those niggas that ain't got no TV frozen. Even if it's artificial ass processed food, they're gonna have it. And the unsuspecting masses who did not prepare are not gonna have it. It'll be provided for you though, because see, I got a constellation of starships that has more food than you can imagine. They can even make the Earth just produce food out of rock. Like the Christian Bible tell you they did for the Israelite children. No, see, that's always been us, melanated people who have that love from the universe. So that's going to be going on with us. Know that. To be the words of God.
There's no dust in my eye.
And all these guys right here, they're just gonna be like the people that's going to wake up and say, you know what? I'm not fighting for these oppressors. I'm gonna do the right thing, and I'm jumping outside with my family, which is the people that ask for hope to protect. And I haven't been doing that since I took this job, and I know that. But I know that there's two judges on the earth right now, and I'm not gonna get caught up inside of the people that these Federation Starship has come to judge. I'm not that smart. Not going to be around long, so why would you want to still be held accountable for having foolish actions that were synonymous with the acquiring of these foolish materials that the Earth is destroying constantly every second? I mean, go figure. And then these bastards might come and just shoot you and kill you any moment anyway. So the only thing you should be doing with your time right now is making preparations to die. And getting your mind sufficiently infested with the right knowledge to help you get pushed to a dimension that is going to be suited for a god or a goddess. And that starts with your understanding the need to be initiated down that road to find your god and God itself. This is a universal principle that will not be overlooked. This is the outcome of oppression and theft and mistreatment and deprivation. All this stuff is coming to an end, okay? Choose real fast what side you're gonna be on, because you don't have much time. You better get your green light.